Good morning, and welcome to Austin Prep's annual Lessons and Carols. This event looks a little different today, but it is very much the same in the sense of the strength of our community and the strength of our faith. The community comes together each year to commemorate the real reason for Christmas, the birth of the Christ child, and the sense of hope and love and joy that he brought 2,000 years ago. 2020 was a challenging year, but it was also a year to be very grateful. And I, for one, paused and said, "Thank you, God, for the gift of life, for our family and friends, which give it meaning, and our faith, which gives it fulfillment." Merry Christmas.
Let us pray. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. We gather here to recall the mystery of our redemption. Though sin drew us away from God, he never stopped loving us. The prophets told of the coming of a Messiah who would initiate a reign of justice and peace. This promise was fulfilled in the incarnation of Jesus Christ. Let us now reflect with joy on this wondrous mystery.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. A shoot will come up from the stump of Jesse. From his roots, a branch will bear fruit. The Spirit of the Lord will rest on him, the spirit of wisdom and of understanding, the spirit of counsel and of might, the spirit of the knowledge and fear of the Lord, and he will delight in the fear of the Lord. He will not judge by what he sees with his eyes or decide by what he hears with his ears, but with righteousness he will judge the needy. With justice he will give decisions for the poor of the earth. The wolf will live with the lamb, the leopard will lie down with the goat, the calf and the lion and the yearling together, and a little child will lead them. The cow will feed with the bear, their young will lie down together, and the lion will eat straw like the ox. The infant will play near the cobra's den, and the young child will put its hand into the viper's nest. They will neither harm nor destroy on all my holy mountain, for the earth will be filled with the knowledge of the Lord as the waters cover the sea. In that day, the root of Jesse will stand as a banner for the peoples. The nations will rally to him, and his resting place will be glorious.
Thank you. A reading from the Gospel of Luke. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was the governor of Syria, and everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph went up from the town of Nazareth to Galilee, to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him, and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born. She gave birth to the firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no guest room available for them.
Thank you.
A reading from the Gospel of Luke. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those in whom his favor rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. When they had seen them, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about the child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told.
nobody knows. A turkey and some mistletoe help to make the season bright. Tiny tots with their eyes all aglow will find it hard to sleep tonight. They know that Santa's on his way. Child is gonna spy to see if reindeer really know how to fly. And so I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92.
On a star and trying to believe that even though it's far, he'll find me Christmas Eve. I guess that Santa's busy, 'cause he never comes around. I think of him when Christmas comes to town. The best time of the year, everyone comes home with all this Christmas cheer. It's hard to be alone. Putting up the Christmas tree with friends who come around, it's so much fun when Christmas comes to town. Presents for the children wrapped in red and green, all the things I've heard about but never really seen. No one will be sleeping on the night of Christmas Eve, hoping Santa's on his way. I've heard about but never really seen. No one will be sleeping on the night of Christmas Eve, hoping Santa's on his way. When Santa's sleigh bells ring, I listen all around. sound. And all the dreams of children, once lost, will all be found. That's all I want when Christmas comes to town. That's all I want when Christmas comes to town.
I sat on Santa's knee and he asked, "Now, what would you like for Christmas?" I knew I could have any gift I could imagine, but the thing I wanted most for Christmas was not inside Santa's giant bag. What I wanted more than anything was one silver bell from Santa's sleigh. When I asked, Santa smiled, then gave me a hug and told enough to cut a bell from a reindeer's harness. The elf tossed it up to Santa. He stood holding the bell high above him and called out, "The first gift of Christmas." A clock struck midnight as elves roared their approval. Santa handed the bell to me, and I put it in my bathrobe pocket. The conductor helped me down from the sleigh. Santa shouted out the reindeer's names and cracked his whip. His team charged forward and climbed into the air. Santa circled once above us, then disappeared into the cold, dark polar sky. As soon as we were back on the Polar Express, the other children asked to see the bell. I reached into my pocket, but the only thing I felt was a hole. I had lost the silver bell from Santa's sleigh. "Let's hurry outside and go look for it," one of the children said. But the train gave a sudden lurch and started moving. We were on our way home. It broke my heart to lose the bell. When the train reached my house, I sadly left the other children. I stood in my doorway and waved goodbye. The conductor said something from the moving train, but I couldn't hear him. "What?" I yelled out. He cupped his hands around his mouth. "Merry Christmas," he shouted. The Polar Express let out a loud blast from its whistle and sped away. On Christmas morning, my little sister Sarah and I opened our presents. When it looked like as if everything had been unwrapped, Sarah found one last small box behind the tree. It had my name on it. Inside was the silver bell. There was a note. "Found this at the seat of my sleigh. Fix that hole in your pocket. Signed, Mr. C." I shook the bell. It made the most beautiful sound my sister and I had ever heard. But my mother said, "Aw, that's too bad." "Yes," my father said, "it's broken." When I had shaken the bell, my parents had not heard a sound. At one time, most of my friends could hear the bell, but as years passed, it fell silent for all of them. Even Sarah found one Christmas that she could no longer hear its sweet sound. Though I've grown old, the bell still rings for me, as it does for all who truly believe.
It's in the ringing of the street corner choir. It's going home and getting warm by the fire. It's true, wherever you find love, it feels like Christmas. A cup of kindness that we share with another. A sweet reunion with a friend or a brother. In all the places you find love, it feels like Christmas. It is the season of the heart, a special time of caring, the ways of love made clear. It is the season of the spirit, the message, if we hear it, is make it last all year. It's in the giving of a gift to another, a pair of mittens that were made by your mother. In all the ways that we show love, it feels like Christmas. A part of childhood we'll always remember. It is the summer of the soul in December. Yes, when you do your best for love, it feels like Christmas. It is the season of the heart, a special time of caring, the ways of love made clear. It is the season of the spirit, the message, if we hear it, is make it last all year. It's in the singing of the street corner choir. It's going home and getting warm by the fire. It's true feels like Christmas. It feels like Christmas. It feels like Christmas. Ho, 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 ho.
I had just nodded off at 4:15 when the spirit of Christmas stepped in through my door. With a great show of sparkles, he decked all my halls in tinsel and twinkles and bright shining balls. I was really quite fond of the trimmings he'd brought, but there's just something missing this Christmas, I thought. Bells, he said. Jingle bells. Bells right away. Bells on a one-horse galloping sleigh. A toy soldier band dressed in matching red sashes, candy cane tongues and marshmallow mustaches. Everyone caroling songs of goodwill, so merry that even the trees can't be still. I shook my head. You are really so kind, but it's just not exactly what I had in mind. He spoke to me then in a whisper of wings. There are gentle things the season brings. Snow that lies, silent as quiet as a mouse, and roads that'll lead to your grandmother's house. 10 lords are leaping as 7 swans swim, and of course Santa Claus, I'm just getting to him. I lifted my chin and stared up at the ceiling. I still wasn't getting that warm Christmas feeling. That's when the spirit of Christmas smiled. Remember, this all began with the child, because it took nothing but love to begin it. It's not really Christmas if love isn't in it. Your tree may be large as the room will allow, with a big yellow star on the uppermost bough. But of one thing I'm certain, I'm sure of one thing, it is love that makes the angels sing. And that's when I got it. That's when I knew. The thing that was missing this Christmas is you. And so then, my darling, wherever you roam, may you always be safe, may you always come home. For as long as the world still spins and still hums, wherever you are and no matter what comes, the best part of Christmas will always be love beneath my Christmas tree.
Thank you. Thank you for having me. God, I love that song, especially when Mr. Williams plays it. I must say, coming to Austin Prep for lessons in carols is always something I have circled on my calendar. I am always so amazed with the incredible talent of your singers and musicians. You all will certainly be on the nice list this year. Speaking of my list, let's see how Austin Prep did this year. Let's see. Wait. This cannot be right. Hold on one second, I'm sorry. According to my elves, 99.887006% of the Austin Prep community is on my nice list. This cannot be. That amount of people would shatter the record set by the class of 1997. Let me check my math. Yep, they had a 98.1225%. Excuse me. Let me work this math. Blah, blah, blah. Carry the one. Move the decimal. Why, yes, this appears to be right. My math is strong, you know. Coach Maraday taught me everything I know. Wait. If this math is right, only one member of the Austin Prep community has landed on my naughty list. Who could this be? Let me check my list. TJ Dysart, nice. Araya Gupta, nice. Marvin Twombly, nice. Kayla Russell, nice. Ethan Luongo, nice. Miss Farrell, nice, yet again. Liam Prigmore, nice. Brianna Fountain, nice. Mr. Morales, nice. Mrs. Choate, nice. TJ Brosnan, nice. Mrs. Greenwood, nice. Mr. Driscoll, nice. Dr. Driscoll, nice. Wait a minute. One of the Driscoll boys became a doctor? Must be Billy. Oh, I wonder which one it could be. Miss Barletta, muy bueno. And Mrs. P, very nice. There are just so many names. But I'll find out who's on my naughty list. You know I check my list twice. Actually, I think I'm just gonna come back to campus next week. Maybe I'll pop in a classroom. Maybe I'll read a book in the library. I certainly will be having dinner in the dining hall. I might even go to one of the team's practices. You just never know where I'm gonna turn up. So, for that one person on the naughty list, you have exactly 2 weeks to move to my nice list. As you know, I know if you've been bad or good. So be good, for goodness sake. Until we meet again, Austin Prep, Merry Christmas!